The upper black line represents 95% probability. Now, if you can see there's a very large gap between the data, but even before the the other one is trying to see where we can continue to pick up. But we'd really like to have a little more data points to frame this so we know what's happening. Essentially, what has happened to the new data down there is the space, the state person, but then it's increasing again. Essentially, it's sort of all the way up here now. Maybe with the previous rate that there's a bit more of a state right here now, the offline and that whole speculation, of course, we need a bit more data up here to analyze this one completely. Next data that I look at is Flint's data, so this is the 14 final part of the data that I look at. As you can see here, this is the data 21. It's a bit more similar to what we're seeing with the water body work a bit slower. We've got those very nice peaks coming down there, we've got the final peak, followed by the solid peak. And this is more similar to what we've seen with the rocket. So it's going to be up that way there with 3.8 seconds per revolution. And in contrast, another footage which I like to look at, which is Alpha. And you can see there's two bonus peaks and it has a very high frequency compared to the other principal object and the rocket body. So if you're using the one, using one peak and not dividing by anything, so driving with the contact of one surface, this footage compares to a in period of propagation of 0.8 seconds per revolution, very fast. So the consideration is that I don't understand the fact that potentially with these cylindrical objects where we're talking about more than one surface. So I don't have a bit of consideration about the space itself, so this is just qualified as you can see. And there's a couple of uncertainties that I want to talk about. So this point looks like that's operational. But here you can see, most of the section is that there's two distinct sections of the telephone, the upper and the lower section. So it's possible that one of these shows actually contracted that upper section back down to the lower section. So maybe it's a bit smaller cylinder, which could be potentially why it's been faster. We're also uncertain about the rotation, so if you imagine this sort of cylinder, it could be rotating along like this, or it could be sort of parallel on the line. There's a couple of things that we definitely like looking further about that, and we want to consider that decision factor that we've been using. So we started on four of the things, which I feel is pretty reasonable, three cylindrical ones. I'm not too sure if the music potentially coming off the top and bottom, but I think a lot of this is speculation at this point. We really need to listen to this a bit further. I found a similar case with the galaxy, so that was another cylindrical object. Again, it was the part of the 0.8 months, which corresponds again to the one that was in the speed of 1.12. Again, it's very fast. So I feel with these cases, it's almost, I feel like it's going to come out more than one surface. Another interesting example that I had was with object interference. So in a number of cases, the system actually ends up in a star or another object. This case is particularly interesting because generally when it's tracking a star, the system sort of realizes and it doesn't lock on properly and then doesn't send down any segment and element data, so when it's used for orbital determination, that data is not actually used. However, in this case, because it's a different object, it actually locks onto the different object and that then creates a problem when it's used for orbital determination. Now, the reason I can figure out the difference between the objects is because this is actually data taken from watchable games in Office Space 3. This is a data from the Office Space 3, which I think that before shouldn't have had any clips. So when I saw this very common clip, I just got away with some difference. If it wasn't style limit for any space data, they don't do off any clips. So what we've seen here is completely different objects, and it's interesting because based on this data, I could predict that, and when we use the orbital determination, that's very exactly the same. So this is essentially being used to identify objects and potentially sort of cause them bad data and prevent them errors in the orbital determination propagation. Okay, this is the conclusion. So what have we actually determined based on this? So we can definitely see that rotating debris due to this is characteristic signal. It's a little bit hard at this point to directly correlate that to extreme here because we're unsure or uncertain actually bouncing off at the moment. So, this further research into that can be very beneficial. However, we can definitely say that there is characteristic signal coming off these objects. I'd also like a significantly longer analysis period to allow for any sort of continued conditions. So, if we're going to try and predict what they're going into the future, we definitely want to analyze these a lot more over months, and in years, even to allow us to determine what's going to happen in the future. The good thing about
Thank you.
got all that fun. Yeah.